Morning students, this is our science class. We are going to see the second session. The first lesson is my body. So the first lesson is my body. You all know what is a body. Body is our physical structure. In this lesson we are going to see our body structure and internal organs and the function of its organ. Okay, now we are going to look on the internal organ. You all know what is the internal organ. Internal organs are inside our body, but some external organs are there that we can see. What all we can see in our body? Eyes, nose, ears, hands, legs, that all we can see. It's called a external organ. Yeah, there are some stomach, lungs, heart. That's our internal organ that we can't see. But it's everything inside our body structure, okay? Now we are going to look into the brain. Yeah, brain is our very important parts in our body. See, this is a brain structure. There are three parts of brain, like forebrain, midbrain and hindbrain. So brain is the commanding center of our body. You know, commanding center. For example, at our home, our mom will command us, right? Wake up and brush your teeth, take a bath and wear your uniform, like this. Our mom commanding at home you every day, right? Like this, our body is commanding us to all our body structure, even external organ and internal organ. The brain is giving a commanding. If, for example, if you want to sit, the command comes from the brain. If you want to walk, the command comes from the brain to walk. It will give the commanding to the leg to walk. Okay, it command to the eyes to see. Like this, our brain is a very important part in our body. It is inside of the skull. Yes, you don't forget. Okay, and the very important point, human brain weight is about 1.3 kg. okay, our weight is, the human brain weight is about 1.3 kg. So don't forget this, students. Okay, now some of the exercises are here. See, brain is our internal organ. Yes, brain is the answer, okay? We can see internal body parts. We can see the internal body parts. I told you, now everything is inside our body structure. We can't see. So internal body parts we can't see. So it's a false. Okay, this is some exercise. If we are all in the school, we can make this exercise. Okay, it's nothing but just sitting around and keeping all the body parts and keeping separate the internal parts and external parts. This is an exercise we can do at our class once the school reopen. Okay, see, now we are going to look into the next point, that is lungs. Lungs is also our internal parts. Okay, it's very spongy like organ. Spongy means like our example we take as our pillow. Okay, it's spongy like organs. It is an internal organ. The main function is taking the oxygen inside and leaving the carbon dioxide. For example, just for a keep your one finger at your nose, near your nose, you can feel one nose. It's a taking the intake the oxygen, and another nose will be releasing the carbon dioxide. So oxygen is good for health, but carbon dioxide is not good for health. Okay, see, in our book it gives some example. Okay, see, look, we take a one balloon, you have to blow it in a bigger. See, when we breathe in, that is the lungs becomes bigger. See, when you breathing inside, that is what we breathe inside, oxygen. When we breathing inside, our lungs will become a very big like a balloon. Okay, once we blow out, that is blow, what we blow out, breathe out, that is carbon dioxide. Okay, the balloon will become small like this. Once we blow out, the lungs will also become small. Okay, when we breathe in, the lungs will be bigger. Once we breathe out, the lungs will be very small, like a balloon. Okay, the balloon is a good example for our lung structure. Okay, so students, we learned the internal organ and brain and the lungs. So this is enough for our class. I'm going to give you some hard words to write. Okay, write it in your classwork. Thank you.